Good afternoon, guys. I hope we had all had a good lunch. The nice arrangements made by the community over here. Thanks to them. Yeah, I'm Srinivas. I'm working for XLQ as a chief architect. Here, I'd like to share some of my tips. Here I would like to share some of the tips that we have been using for authentication and authorization using JavaScript technologies. We know that JavaScript now become like a mainstream platform for the application development. And a lot of server-side aspects of coding and the features are now coming towards client-side for the better usage of client-side resources. So there are problems around authentication, authorization, which is a common problem across no matter what framework you've been using, Angular, Backbone, or your own JavaScript also. Okay, so when you are using Angular or any other framework particularly, there are cases like at every service level or at every component level, you are authenticating, authorizing, which is like a clutter. There's a lot of clutter of code, clumsy, and it is difficult to debug and maintain also. So what are the different design patterns we can apply that server side, the same principles you can carry to the client side also, even you are using your own JavaScript framework or your own developed JavaScript. Particularly if you take a look at Angular JavaScript framework, there are components provided by the AngularJS like interceptor, directive, and different events, eventing mechanism. So combination of these different components you can use to develop a nice authentication authorization service. For example, if you use interceptor, any HTTP call you're making, you can use HTTP provider to register your own logic for authentication authorization, and which gets called on all service requests to validate whether the required service is authenticated to the given user or authorized to or not. The same way that is it audible? Okay. The same way nowadays there is a lot of ajaxination calls from the client side, and there is a lot of partial page renderings. So how do you evaluate whether the given page or the piece of fragment is allowed to a given user logged in or not? So you can very well use the nice features of HTML5 semantics formatting. You can use, you can define your own attribute to the HTML5 tags, which is in a way used by AngularJS directives and all. So you can use directives frameworks also, and underlying you can call the same services that you developed for interceptors to authenticate and authorize the request. So that way, for example, if you are using your own AJAX, simple HTML, XML, HTTP request, you can still wrap your own code around the XML HTTP request object and define it as an interceptor. Define it as an interceptor instead of using any particular framework also.
Sorry to interrupt, sir. You have 2 minutes to go. You have two more minutes to go.
So that way, you can very well organize modular your code and better implement authentication authorization services, which are in general common problems to solve across different client-side frameworks. And particularly, how you can store the local store, like credential store. You can use either local service, but there are possible hacks that using a lot of JavaScript development tools, one can hack it. So better you can encrypt and use it as a local store, or you can integrate OAuth like service also from the same interceptor or directive. Okay. So I think combination of different techniques. Definitely you must have implemented different techniques in your own application development also. I'm very happy to hear any such other alternative solutions also. Okay. Thank you very much. Thanks for giving me opportunity.